Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We are going to discuss reaction coordinates or reaction coordinate diagrams. On the screen we have written, this is a fairly typical reaction coordinate diagram. They don't always look exactly like this, but a lot of them will look exactly like this. So we have an energy axis, that's our y-axis, and our x-axis is something called the reaction coordinate. Sometimes people will label it the extent of reaction. This is what's happening energetically to our system as the reaction progresses. I kind of think of this as watching a movie. This is almost like a time axis as the reaction progresses. Now, on this curve, we need to think about what's happening on this curve. In every reaction, we have a starting material and a product, and these tend to be fairly low energy states. And so our starting material tends to be over here on the right, and our product ends up being over on the right. And these humps in this curve give us an indication of how this conversion happens from starting material to product. So we're leaning towards insight into the reaction mechanism. Now the curve gives us changes in energies, and so we can sketch out here, if that's where our starting material and that's where our product is, we can say that difference that's the change in energy between our starting material and our product. And we can say things like, oh, this results in a decrease in energy, therefore this is going to be a spontaneous process if we think of E as being delta G, free energy change. Or the reactions can be uphill as well. Typically, our reactions are all going to be downhill processes, so the products will be drawn at lower energy than the starting materials. This particular curve has two humps, two peaks. The number of peaks, the number of peaks in this curve is equal to the number of steps in our reaction. And that's the number of mechanistic steps, and we'll have to learn about that idea later. Now, each step will have its own barrier. Just because this reaction is favorable because our delta E is negative, there's still an energetic barrier from the starting material to that peak. And this is our energy of activation. And since we have two peaks, we have two steps, each step has its own energy of activation. The highest peak, the tallest peak, meaning the highest point on the energy axis, that is our rate determining step. There are other features on this curve. Our peaks themselves are denoted as transition states, and we tend to write those as TS. Often you'll see TS written in brackets, and you'll see the double dagger symbol put on that bracket, and that's a special symbol to denote that it's a transition state. We also have a valley in this particular curve, and that corresponds to a reaction intermediate, which some people will write I. Oftentimes, though, they will put it in brackets without the double dagger symbol. So that's a symbol for an intermediate. So we've covered a lot of terminology in this slide, a lot of different definitions. But as we go through the course and we encounter multiple reactions, we'll very often draw a reaction coordinate diagram as a way to communicate how does this reaction proceed, and we'll use that to determine how do we figure out what the mechanism for that process will be.